Okay, so for lasagna, it's pretty simple. You need a bechamel sauce. I just doubled the normal proportion, meaning 80 grams of flour, 80 grams of butter, and 80 centiliters of milk, up to 1 liter, honestly, of whole milk. And then a good bolognese with 1.5 pound of corned beef, plus a bottle of tomato sauce and tomato concentrate, like those two guys, and a bit of wine, white or red, like half a glass. Then choose your plate, cover it with butter, and then it's a question of just assembly. So first, start with a layer of bechamel. And as you can see, the bechamel is pretty liquid because we will use it to cook the pasta. So the pasta will take the liquid, and so it won't be as liquid after they cook. So cover a good layer, otherwise it's gonna stick to the mold, and you don't want that. Then you add those dry. So I love the one from Trader Joe's. And you chew the oven ready ones. Otherwise it's really a burden to pre-cook them. Then cover it all with, like, you cut pieces from those additional, like this. You don't need to make it perfect, honestly. Once it's cooked, you don't see the difference. So just make sure that you have enough. Okay, so that's it. Once this is done, then you add first a layer of meat, and actually don't add too much. It doesn't need to have too much sauce. So add a bit like this everywhere. Ta ta ta. Okay, here. So usually I'm pretty generous on the first layers. Okay, and then again the bechamel. And again, don't add too much. I love this spoon. It's kind of a big one. And so it helps me to be more precise while being efficient. Okay, so that's it for the first layer. And then you continue like this until you fill the mold. So you continue. See you at the end. Okay, so that's the last layer, and as you can see, I still have some room. I still have some room because everything is gonna increase in size while the pasta will cook. They will double in width, so I prefer to have room for the lasagna to expand. And to finish with, I'm gonna add a layer first of the remaining bechamel, and I will add just few drops of bolognese just to give it some color, and finally add cheese. Okay, so that's the layer of bechamel, not super thick, as you can see, and then some drops of bolognese just to give it a bit of color. It's always nicer. And don't worry too much, because while it will cook, it's gonna melt all together. So don't worry if it doesn't look super pretty. Doesn't matter. Okay. And for the cheese, I'm gonna use a Parmigiano. So I do preheat the oven at 350 Fahrenheit, which is 180 Celsius. I also put some tin foil on the grid, and as you can see, I create a kind of barrier all around because sometimes while it cooks, some of the sauce will drop outside of the mold. So I don't want my oven to be completely burnt out. So I prefer to be precautious and to add that kind of tinfoil all around. And it's gonna cook for, I think, something like 40 minutes. But you can check and see how it goes.